Hi kiddos, it's Riley, and I am back today with another age-read video for you all. Today we are going to be talking about something that is incredibly important, especially within the online age regression community, and that is cross-tagging. If you don't know what cross-tagging is, it's basically using one community's tags along with another community's tags, usually when those two communities do not want to be tagged together. The best example of this is using safe for work and not safe for work tags on the same post. Now, I do want to give a little warning and disclaimer before I get into this video. We will be talking briefly about NSFW terms, and there will be mentions of kink communities. So if you are already aware of this and uncomfortable with that, feel free to skip this video. There will also be brief touches on mental illness and trauma, so prepare yourself for that if you choose to stick around. For the purposes of this video and why I'm making it, I'm going to be using examples that are primarily related to the age regression online community. So examples of some safer work tags are AgeRe, Regression, KidCore, CGLRe. The re on the end of that is very important. SFW Age Regression. Tags like Princess, Sanrio, Care Bears are also safe for work tags, meaning that they are appropriate tags. When you go into those tags, most of the time you're expecting content that would be appropriate in most circumstances to show to children or your boss or just your average person in your life. However, examples of some not safe for work or NSFW tags are BDSM, ABDL, DDLG, Pet Play, Age Play, and CGL. I'm not going to go into detail on what all of those terms and acronyms mean. It is not my place, nor is it my community to discuss. Those are just some examples of not safe for work tags that you might see. Cross-tagging is when you see tags like the safer work tags I mentioned and the not safer work tags I mentioned used together on the same post or on the same account. Why is this dangerous? Why is this a bad thing? Well, I will tell you. First things first, it exposes inappropriate photos and subjects to groups of people who shouldn't see it. Using tags like DDLG and Princess together exposes minors to kinks that they should not be exposed to. Kinks are strictly 18 plus and inherently not safe for work and should not be public on any social media platform, let alone put into safer work tags where a kid could stumble across it. It also exposes trauma survivors to triggering subjects, because there could be a trauma survivor just going and scrolling through the age regression tag and then see a kink post by a kinkster who is cross-tagging with DDLG and AgeRe, and it can be really upsetting as somebody who's been there. And it doesn't matter if you're regressed in the moment or not, because unfortunately for a lot of people in the age regression community, the kink community is a trigger, which is another big reason why these two things should not be tagged together. They should not be tagged together on the same account. They should not be mixed under any circumstances. A lot of folks who regress have some kind of trauma tied to kink communities such as DDLG and ABDL, myself included. So when you're scrolling through a regression tag expecting to see regression safe posts and you stumble across kink content, it can be really upsetting. And this is me, an adult, saying this. I don't want to see that content when I have not consented to see it. So please keep that content in the designated tags. Don't cross-tag it with other tags. To be completely honest, if it's not safe for work content, it shouldn't be public on a 13 plus platform to begin with. It also wrongfully sexualizes innocent things and coping mechanisms. Using both kink and AgeRe tags on the same posts equates kink to being AgeRe and AgeRe to being kink, which could not be further from the truth. And it gives the wrong idea to people who may be stumbling across it because of the cross-tagging. It implies age regression is something it's not, and it also implies kink is something it's not, which is just as dangerous. So honestly, for the safety of both the kink Inc. and the regression community, there should not be cross-tagging under any circumstances from either side. If you don't know if you might be cross-tagging, my biggest advice is to ask somebody in the community who uses tags on their posts. Most people won't have an issue answering if you think you might be cross-tagging or asking, hey, do you know of any safe tags for me to use in this community? I don't think I know a single person on Instagram who would be rude to someone for asking a question like that. It's really easy to just ask and interact with other people, observe what tags other people are using on their posts, and take the information from there. You got this. You can figure it out. And I'm not gonna list all the tags because there are hundreds upon hundreds and there's just way too many. But if you ask around and do a little observing, you'll be able to find out what's cross-tagging and what's not, and just steer clear of using common kink terms, obviously, in tags if you are a Safer Work regression account. So overall, cross-tagging is dangerous for all of these reasons and because it leads to kink and NSFW accounts infiltrating regression spaces, or the other way around, regression accounts infiltrating kink spaces, which is just on the same plane, not okay. We need to have our own space. We need to keep it separate, and that's okay. But we cannot be mixing these two things. They cannot be cross-tagged. They cannot be shared. It's dangerous for the minors that are in the regression community. It's dangerous for the adults in the kink community. It's dangerous for the adults in the regression community. It is dangerous for everyone involved. So long story short, don't cross-tag. It's really easy not to. I hope this video was informational for some of you. I know to some of you who might be new to the online communities, this might be a new issue to you. As someone who's been in the online age group community since they were like 14, I have been around, I have seen some things, I have a little bit of experience in this area. I definitely don't know everything, but I have been around the block once or twice. And I think it's important to share this information, especially with people who are newer in the online community, to keep everybody as safe as humanly possible. If you enjoyed this video and or would like to see more age regression content from me, you can subscribe to this channel because I post over here a couple of times a week. But if you would like to keep up with me day to day in between uploads, you can follow me over on Instagram, which is at Crayons and Pencils, or over on Twitter, which is at Crayon Kiddo. I have a link to my Ko-fi down below, my wish list, a link so you can buy my Adria's for Everyone merch, which you can get on t-shirts, mugs, sweatshirts, stickers, I mean everything you can imagine. It's awesome. I would check it out. Those are all linked in the description if you want to help support me and my content, or you can just let my ads play through. That really helps too. I love you guys so very much, and I will see you soon. Goodbye.